Start with the biggest losers right now. The biggest of the lot is Infosys Technologies. I mean, no surprises there. We've been highlighting that here since the morning. The stock made a low of about 23.07 or so. It's recovered to about 23.20 right now. There you go. That's what I'm talking about. Still about 3.5% down. And most of the sell-off has come over the last 30, 40 minutes or so. I mean, it was low by about 0.5%, 0.75% for most parts of the session till now. But over the last 30, 40 minutes, it sold off significantly. Single biggest drag on the market as well. Arcom is down 3%. The DLF is selling off about 2.75%. IDFC is down about 2.5%. BHEL is selling off about 2.5%. Reliance Power is down 2.5%. Grasim is down 2.25%. Hindalco is down. Tata Power, JSPL, I mean, pretty much everything trending lower. Just focusing on large caps. About 40 out of the 50 Nifty stocks are lower. The ones which are up are SAIL, Tata Steel, and RIL. That's about it. I mean, these three stocks have got gains in excess of 1%. That's SAIL, Tata Steel, and Reliance Industries. SAIL has got 2.5%. Tata Steel has got 1.33%. Reliance just over barely 1% by way of gains. All right. Large volume movers include, I mean, your usual suspects, GVK, Lanco Infratech, HDIL, Suzlon, Arcom, you got SpiceJet, BHEL, Sri Renuka Sugars, but most of them on the way down. So, I mean, anything between 2 to 3.5, 4% cuts on all these stocks that I'm talking about here today. Pull up the rupee equation as well. I mean, that's been falling off quite significantly. I mean, amongst most currencies right now trading, rupee seems to be the weakest against the US dollar in terms of how much it is losing. 52.28 on that currency cross. That's almost 0.5% lower compared to the US dollar. I mean, that's going one way, and that's south. Jyoti Vardhan Jaipuria is joining in right now to run us through his thoughts of on what's going on. Head of research at Bank of America Merrill Lynch. So we're going to focus on the rupee first off, and then we'll sort of correlate it back to what he's seeing in the marketplace, stock market, that is. Jyoti, afternoon. Thanks very much for your time.
Hey, afternoon.
What would you attribute this, I mean, extended leg of weakness in the rupee to, Jyoti?
Yes, if you see the rupee, what we had is a big move up in the rupee since the beginning of the year after, you know, a sharp depreciation last year. Current account deficit is still a worry. We have a huge current account deficit which we are running. And if we see flows now, you know, in the first quarter of the year, we had huge flows coming in from FIIs. The flows have tended to weaken off and flatten out in April. And that is starting to be a worry. As you know, in the first quarter, the balance of payments was negative, which is like current, the account deficit was higher than the capital inflows we had. So, you know, fundamentally, the rupee is getting a bit weak, and that's what is starting to play out. The other thing is, you know, we've highlighted this in a report that somewhere our forex reserves of the last 5 years have been flat. But if you look at forex reserves today as a percentage of the imports we have or as a percentage of GDP, forex reserves are not as strong as they are. So now, you know, we have forex reserves which are less than 8 months of import. The last time we had this was way back in 96. So we are at a 15-year low in some sense on the forex reserves. So, you know, fundamentally, RBI will have to play this carefully. They don't want to jump in and intervene very easily because they want to try and drag this. They'll prevent a sharp depreciation or appreciation of the rupee. But my guess is their firepower is not as high as it was like 4 or 5 years ago.
I mean, so can we expect a sharp fall in the rupee from here, Jyoti? I mean, which basically breaks 54.5 or so, which was the low?
Yeah, see, my guess is what RBI will try and do from now on is, you know, let the rupee depreciate or appreciate in line with the dollar movement across various currencies. So what they'll try and prevent is India depreciating very sharply against the dollar if the other currencies are not depreciating. But if, you know, globally, like the dollar is appreciating against all currencies, I don't think they're going to fight that. So they'll probably not fight a dollar move, but they'll probably try and prevent any sharp appreciation by intervening in the market.
Do you have the NDTV Profit app? all the markets, all the news in your own homemade, ready-made portfolio available there for you.
We will right now answer what you should sell, what you should buy when markets are down.
Download at indietvprofit.com/apps. Get the best app from the channel you trust.